Okay, we are back at it. Justice League Crisis on Infinite Earths, another Justice League animated movie, barely a week after my What Happened to DC Animation's video. You can find that on my channel in the video's log. But back to this, a new DC animation with the Flash as the pivotal character, where the multiverse is crashing and collapsing due to an antimatter wave. The Monitor makes his debut in DC Animations, may not be his debut, but I have never seen him in any of the past 30 to 40 DC Animations and series over the years. I know there's an anti-monitor in the DC universe. I saw that in the comics. I think they were responsible for creating universes or life on universes or something along those lines. But back to the topic at hand, the multiverse is being destroyed by the antimatter wave, and the Monitor has gathered Earth's mightiest heroes to brainstorm a way to end the annihilation. We got a semblance of Justice League Crisis on Two Earths from this movie. The multiple timelines and multiverse crashing with the added flavor of Lex Luthor. Amazo also made a return. We saw him first in Batman Under the Red Hood, and I don't think he has been back ever since. There were really no surprises here. Maybe some obscure characters were brought to the big screen, but majority of the themes in this movie had been touched by previous movies. The Justice Syndicate had been touched in Crisis on Two Earths, Amazo was in Batman Under the Red Hood, Lex Luthor has been a common theme since the Justice League Unlimited series, the multiverse collapse might have been the novelty of this movie, and it all goes back to things I said in my early DC video. We got the multiverse broken for unspecified reasons, and I'm sure we'll get them in part 2, why the Flash is running through and against time to figure out the common thread linking their destruction. We got multiple superhero appearances, very few action scenes, and a lot of dialogue. So I'm asking, was this a soap opera or a superhero movie? Because a majority of the screen time was devoted to showing the Flash's relationship with the people in his life. Personally, I wasn't moved. Everything I saw here were things I had seen before, barring the antimatter wave, and that was the singular highlight of this movie. They've run through these characters and villains multiple times over. The Batman who laughs is literally an appropriate villain for a multiverse collapse. Instead, we got an antimatter wave with no known source or instigator. I know they are setting up a part 2, but I mean, I do not have any realistic enthusiasm for it. When it drops, I'll still watch it, but it's not like I'm anticipating its release impatiently. Come on, DC. We've seen these themes before. If you are going to use them, why not introduce something or someone who hasn't been on the big screen for once? Why did they even go away from the art style that was used in the Justice League War era? From 2015 to about 2020, they used that art style, then dumped it in the favor of this, and believe me, it is a noticeable downgrade. They also somehow decided to lighten up the tone of the movies, so we've got less blood, less gore, or rampaging destruction. If this is the trend, then I'm afraid DC has peaked with the Justice League War era. Those were some of the most intense, visually pleasing animated series in DC Animation's history, so maybe they changed the animation studios or personnel, but I won't say it has been welcome. Regardless of how good or bad anyone thinks this movie is, the reality again is DC have produced another film with little fanfare, awareness, or hype. Hell, I've seen more conversations about Marvel's Madame Web, which everyone knows is going to be a dud, than this movie. I spoke on this earlier in my What Happened to DC Animations video. How has Marvel been able to generate anticipation and hype around their releases, no matter the quality, while DC simply drops theirs like a thief in the night, slinking through the quiet darkness? They've got the budget and the backing, so why does this still happen? I cannot imagine an Avengers team movie or series, whether animated or not, being released in the same manner DC has done with Crisis on Infinite Earths. Barring that, this was a middling movie at best, and I hope the sequel is a lot better, because they have not moved me an inch from this first movie. This is still the Bootleg Corner. Don't forget to subscribe, hit us with your thoughts in the comment section. Keep it locked in, and bye for now.